and a shout out to all you viewers out here today. Mary Jo and I are here to talk to you about Pray First. We've been in this great series that we've been doing on Thursdays at Journey at 5 p.m. And we can't thank you whether you're watching it live right now or whether you'll be watching it on demand later. If you haven't gotten one of the physical Pray First guides, you can download one at journeychurch.org/pray. If you have one with you, go ahead and pull it out and turn to page 13, because that's where we're going to be diving into today. And we're really putting an end cap to a section that we've been studying for the past few weeks. We've been talking about the Lord's Prayer. It's a great way to pray. We've been going through this framework of really talking about how we should pray. If you look at all the way back to page 5, let me go back there. On page 5, there's an interesting section of scripture in Luke 11:1. It says, "One day Jesus was praying in a certain place, and when he finished, one of his disciples said to him, 'Lord, teach us to pray.'" Yeah. And that's really what these Thursdays have been about, learning how to pray, looking at models of prayer that are found in the Bible, and then trying to apply them in our everyday lives. So if you look at Matthew 6:9-13, it's the fullness of the Lord's Prayer. Today we're going to study the very end of it, but let me go back to the beginning and just read it from the start. "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen." So we've been breaking down those verses, and when it opens up, you see him talking about this praise unto God, lifting up and glorifying God. And when he's closing out the prayer, he's really in many ways doing the same things, but reminding us of God's power in the midst of the difficult circumstances of life. So if we move to our main portion of the teaching today in verse 13, we're coupling that last verse, "For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever," with Jeremiah 32:17. It says, "Sovereign Lord, you have made the heavens and the earth by your great power and outstretched arm. Nothing is too hard for you." Man, God is good even in the midst of difficult circumstances. And we've had a few of those in the course of our lives. We've been married for a very long time. and we've had a lot of those experiences. And a lot of you might be going through things right now. And as Mary Jo and I were preparing and talking about it, I know you've got some thoughts on what we've already read.
Well, Eric has asked me to share one of the things that was, I really needed God. I really needed to dig in and walk in faith in that I wasn't going to be blindsided by Satan's plans because something had attacked our family. It was huge and it was hard and it was about a 3-year period, but we thought it was going to be for the rest of our lives. One of our children had gotten sick and he was diagnosed with just mental health issues, and he had been on medication. We had seen the specialist one after another, and the diagnosis that was put on him was one that was going to be forever, and I wasn't going to stand for that. We ended up just really, I went to deliverance classes, I read the Bible, I had scriptures written out, I read them every morning, I read them every night, I wrote them out for him, had him read them, and I just knew that God's word was true. You told me, I'll never forget, we were in the car when we had gotten the news, and you said, "God is bigger than this." And I couldn't see that at the time. I was like, this thing that was put over him was bigger than anything I could ever imagine. And when you said, "God is bigger than this," I said, "Yes, he is." And we just really dug in, and we believed, and for about 3 years, wasn't it, that we would wake up to whatever craziness and hardship and sadness, and our reality really stunk. And we just trusted God. I remember over and over again, Pastor had taught me something years and years ago. He had said, if you have a rifle and you have ammunition, that's a fight in the physical, but there's also a fight in the spiritual. And he said, unfortunately, we cannot, when you have a rifle, you can shoot it and you can see the damage that bullet does. But when we're praying in the spiritual realm, there is no proof. We just have to trust God. We just have to believe his word. He says that he will defend us. He says that he will take care of us. He says that he will have a table before our enemies, that no disease shall touch us, that you know, by his stripes we are healed. So we knew all of this. We had the word in us, but now it was so close to us. Now it really hit home. And we had to really dig in and say, Lord, is your word really true? Is your word really real? And yes, his word is. And so in the natural, you see where the bullet goes. In the supernatural, you have to walk in faith. You have to believe God's word. You need to know God's word. You need to stand on it. When people will tell you and circumstances will tell you different things, you said, nope, God tells me this. And you got to stand on his word. And I believe that's what we did. Our son now stands full, whole, no medication, married, children, loving and serving the Lord. And I believe with all my heart, it's because we did not waver. We did not lay across the bed and cry. We did not...
You did that a couple times.
We did. Yeah, in the beginning, let me tell you, I laid across that bed and cried. But now to look and just see, that just built up our faith so much. Other things come at us, being pastors, you know, seeing different circumstances. We know the word. We know the truth. We know he wins. Satan is a liar. God took all his power from him from the very beginning. So anything that we think the power that Christ, that Satan has over us, he doesn't. He's defeated. He's done. So the only thing he has on us is the fear we let him have.
Yep.
And so when we say he is healed, he is whole, he is a child of God, Satan's not going to get his foothold in this family.
Nothing's impossible.
Nothing is impossible with God. So I love this ending and how he's telling us to stand, that he's the power, that it's his glory, and it is.
And I think we all need to learn. I learn a lot from prayer from Mary Jo, because I've heard this phrase a couple times recently. They said, there's a couple people that came out and they said, I'm a spiritual sniper. We were listening to that thing the other day. And, you know, going with Mary Jo's analogy, you know, that's the kind of precision that she has in her prayer that I think, as we're talking about learning how to pray and going deeper in our prayer life, at staff, we've been really talking about a shift that we believe is taking place and a new season that we're about to enter into.
Amen.
And it's not going to come about except through prayer, except through fasting, except through passionately seeking after the Lord.
Yep.
And we believe that things are going to get tough out there in the natural. But at the same time, nothing is too hard for our God. And God wants to release revival. God wants to create a shift and to continue on in the same spirit that we've been talking about of learning how to pray at our own homes. You know, we've always had the first Thursday prayer meeting, and we're going to continue with that. It is an amazing time of gathering together in God's word and worshiping together corporately. But for the month of September, we're going to do something special. We're going to go deeper in applying these principles. And every Thursday night, during the month of September at 7 p.m., we're going to do a prayer and praise and worship service that night. So I want to encourage you right now, anybody who's watching, to begin to adjust your schedule, put it on there, that if you want to go deeper, if you want to learn how to be a spiritual sniper, but you feel like you're barely getting by right now, and you want to be able to apply these things in spiritual warfare and begin to understand the depths of the power that you possess because the Holy Spirit is in you, that you don't have to continue getting beat up by the devil. You don't have to continue getting beat up by circumstances. You can get the victory in Christ Jesus. And that's really a lot of what he's talking about in here as well. So we're excited, looking forward to what we're going to be doing on those Thursday nights. I know you are looking forward to it as well.
I love it.
Anything else you'd like to share before we close?
No.
All right, then. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. Would you like to close us in prayer today?
Absolutely.
Mary Jo's going to close us in prayer. Continue to pray first, and hope to see you on those Thursday nights as well. We love you guys.
Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we just love you so much, and we're so thankful that we are reminded time and time again that your word wins out over all. You have defeated our foe, Father God. You have a covering over your believers, Lord, as we trust in you, as we abide in you, as we live under you and your lordship, Father God, that you protect us from even sickness and disease, Father God. You protect us from losing our jobs, Father God. You protect us from our cars breaking down, Lord Jesus. You are our God, and you care about everything that we walk through, Father God. So we just thank you right now, Lord. We thank you. We thank you for this prayer. We thank you that you teach us how to pray, Father God. We thank you that you hear our prayers and that you answer them, Lord. We cast all of our cares onto you, Lord Jesus. We stand firmly and boldly on your truth, on your word, and on your ways. In Jesus' name we pray, and we all say, amen.
Nothing is too difficult for God. God bless you guys. Have a great day.